Well, he was very thrilled to be asked to do a piece for Gloucester Cathedral, and he thought the sound would be right. I think he felt it was all the things he'd known about and heard about and was related to his hymn books, related to his folk song collecting, and he did it exactly as he thought it should be.
I saw at the performance for the first time in my life the composer Ralph Vaughan Williams, looking magnificent, dark hair, clear-cut features, then the music, filling the sounds with gravely passionate phrases, and probably becoming, in the moment of its performance, a great conundrum to a large part of that audience, so that one can say at the end it probably confused more than it converted.